This is taken near the 13. And a good return. He's across the 35-yard line, right around the 36. And San Francisco gets set to go here. Coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. They go play action here on first down. Down in, it's Bashaun Perriman. But he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. A good pickup there, 26 yards. So here we go, first and 10 now. Stick skills, but didn't get a ton from it. Stopped short of the 35. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. So second and 9, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Should have had it. Third down now.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been two drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first.
Secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up fourth. So on fourth down, out comes the field goal unit for Todd Bowles. This from 54 yards away. And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So after the missed long field goal attempt, this offense set up nicely at the 44-yard line. Red zone opportunity.
Back down it up, Philly. Here we go. Back down it up, Philly. Here we go. Here we go. 3-19. Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
Now a play fake here on first down. And it's caught at the 7-yard line. That's good for a gain of 6. Second and goal.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks, but doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
Go left, go left. possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the two or the three in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick-hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. If you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
Early
on, right? Third and short, they elect to throw for it, and that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you've got to hit it, don't you?
Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect there. And Lambeau will put this one through, and the lead moves to 10-10. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach, but it kept the offense out of the end zone.
This fielded at the two. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The 49ers offense now, they get set to head back on the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah,
you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers. They set up the screen to Hill. First by him near the 35. There goes Jeremy Hill. 20, 10, touchdown, four. Jeremy Hill, 72 yards. And the 49ers are able to strike quickly for six. Well, he's used to running at that distance. Here he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Happened to play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
Sturgis out now to kick this one off. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were right within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points. Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
Super tough.
Under a minute to go. Clock running at a back and forth first quarter of play. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Looking to throw on second down. Clock. He'll throw underneath for Gurley. Good move by Gurley. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Second quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, and they've got it here with a first down. Shift together here from the D-line. Territory just across midfield at the 49.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
They'll run it now with Pumphrey. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here. Will go from incomplete to complete.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store.
Because I think what happens is he just had too much time to think. He's wide open now. Here comes the ball. And he doesn't concentrate and drops it.
Defensively there, as you said, just to knock it free, because if he had caught that pass the sticks, first down. And that one will be no good. He never had it online. It's well wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is. So an empty possession there. What do you think went wrong, Charles?
Well, it looked like maybe the plant leg might have given way just a little. And when that happens, guys have a tendency to pull through the ball to compensate. And in doing so, set this one off target.
Ohio! Here we go!
And here comes throw number one for the backup QB. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, Makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
For a loss of six. And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively.
Safety valve that's built like this guy. Big target, guy you can spot pretty easily. Put it on him when your other targets aren't open.
Now, look at this. No. Check. Patrick. Leopard. All right, here we go. Leopard. Over. Back down it up. Over.
Looking to throw on second down. Looking right side, and that's complete to Watkins. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to the booth right after this. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Let's go! 3-19!
On the run, it's Pumphrey. And he'll get across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this 3rd and long play as we'll get a timeout. As they'll talk it over here before what'll be an important 3rd down. And this offensive unit, they have to face a 3rd down and 12 now. So on 4th down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. This is taken at the 18. It wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Niners will go on offense. First and 10. Timeout instead, as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So it'll be first down here after the run.
Turnover. I feel like I might have him a little bit off balance. I prefer to take a shot, but a lot of coaches will tell you you only do it if you trust the guy who's got the football in his hands. Meaning, if it's not there, he won't force it downfield and maybe turn into an interception. They'll go to the check down, go to a second option, and go and take the play that's in front of them.
They run with Pumphrey. And he's brought down. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game. I've yet to meet a wide receiver who likes to block more than catching the football, but the best ones understand that that's how they'll actually get more passes thrown to them if they help in the run game. But anytime you get a run of that yardage, that means the wide receivers did help. They get down to what a lot of people call the second level, the linebackers, or the third level where the defensive backs are, and they get out in front and put their bodies out there and create more space for their runners to gain the yardage. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. To throw on second down. Boy. This is caught, and he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. The Rams going to be forced to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 20 seconds to go in the first half. Two receivers left, two to the right. Operating from the gun. And he is going to go down. Back at the 11-yard line.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the two, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the two, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year. as we send you across the country to Orlando. Standing by there, Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. Short boot, take it at the 21. Field position as they get it up past the 35. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. They have the lead now. They'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt, show him one thing, hit him with something else.
And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It'll be a gain of 9, and it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. At the 49-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and we'll still get the first down. They love being physical.
So the penalty by the offense, and now they face a first and 15. Just across midfield at the 49. It's a gain of 7, and that'll make this a second down.
Completion that made it very difficult.
The Rams on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 8.
Considering it, just know that you're probably going to get the ball back. Good job declining that penalty.
the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Here's a look at the 49ers offense as they make their way out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because
that's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense. Get the ball back for offense. And go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen. But they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards or you mean the magic marker board?
Yeah, those two.
On the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
He's got his man in the crossing route. 8 yards there on a first down.
Many different ways to create space, but on that play, he did it with that big, wide body of his. Didn't get a whole lot of yardage on the play, but it did what it was supposed to pick up a first down.
First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're able to just roam and hit.
Daniels. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Jamarcus Lawrence in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. The Niners on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and 19.
Come on, let's go!
From the gun, Daniels. And this is going to be incomplete.
We're into the second half now. This is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know, the rhythm seems off. Here is the punter, Shum, as he sends this one away. It's taken to the 26. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles.
This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap, jump too quickly.
time to the tailback. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
An opportunity to get a drive started here at the end of the third quarter. What you're trying to do is break the game down a little bit. Don't let your guys see too deep into the game, into the future, and say, oh, we got to get here. No, right here, right in front of them, melt the clock down, get to the fourth quarter, try and keep going.
And try to keep that lead.
Exactly.
Now here in Santa Clara, it's the Rams out in front here. They've got control of the football as well as we get set for the fourth quarter.
Chance of the football right there. You've got a lead. You've got to protect it. And he's taking chances, putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, fourth quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. They'll step off the 5 yards.
Yeah, partner, you know, defensive end, he wants to get into the offensive backfield. He wants that get off to be as fast as possible. A little too quick on that.
Watch it now. Marty, 40, 10, 3, 19. 3, 19. Good. No. Check. Patriot. Here we go now. Blue 90. All right, now. Look, watch it now. Marty, 40.
Looking to throw on second down. Oh, he's got a little daylight. 30. Past the 20. And into the end zone. Pick 6 for the 49ers as they score the touchdown. And growing pains is an NFL QB. They're going to happen. He's played pretty well in this one. They still have the lead. But those moments, interceptions, pick 6 is occasionally going to happen.
Rookie. It happens, right? Just what you mentioned. Played pretty well in this game, and now his teammates will jump in and go, okay, we're having a good game. That's one blip. Let's go ahead and get back on track right here, right now, and we'll be okay.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Rams offense now making their way out to take over. And following the pick 6, and they had decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football. But they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bathema Bible, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is, don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. Throwing for his linebacker. He's got it complete. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
All right, here we go. Detroit!
Play clock winding down.
Back out it up, Philly. Here we go.
On first down. He lost the football. And that was a scooped up by the 49ers. Second half, Charles, after that play.
All you're trying to do is change momentum, flip things around for your team. You're just trying to take the ball away. How about when you take it away and score? That really changes things.
All right, now what can the Niners do as they face a big two-point conversion here?
Here we go!
Will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Rams now coming out on the field. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track.
And this is where the coach is walking that line of being calm and really being firm with his team. Had one tell me once, you know, when we're having a tough patch. This too shall pass, this too shall pass. And finally kept having a rough patch. Said, but you got to do something to make it pass. And that's what they have to do. They've got to get some control back, get themselves reasserted, and calm things down.
See if they can get calm and reassert themselves here. And they give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
Space to complete a pass and find open room to run. This defense all night long has squeezed down the passing lanes, made plays on the football. It's really been a thing of beauty for them. He's got to figure all day long prepping for the game. They had to have talked about it again and again. Squeeze passing lanes and we'll be in great shape.
There and it moves the chains. Here for the offensive unit.
Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
Now a handoff here to his running back. Oh, and now he pulls him over. And they get this one down to about the 20-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a flesh set of downs. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
time is starting to run out, really becoming a factor. We'll see if the defense can get the stop they need to get the ball back to the offense.
Here we go. Brad 38. Brad 38.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. And his defense here going to burn their second timeout. But you can also factor in another timeout that they'll get when the clock stops at the two-minute warning. And the offense here just looking to stay in bounds, complete the short passes, and put this game on ice. And no press coverage here. They are backing off in the secondary. The third of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the two-minute warning to stop it from here on out. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Los Angeles, and they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Back to throw. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught, but got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
Throw deep downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground and it brings up third. Trying to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
The Rams on third down. Just 1 for 5 to this point. This is third and 10.
Comes time for the games to count.
And a great spot to start this drive from here. give it here to his running back. And they'll get him down right about the 20. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Now contact up front as penalty markers come in. Who is this against? A free 5 yards as the defense jumps.
I know it's an anticipation game for them, but it's also a reaction game, and they reacted poorly on that one.
He stopped right around the 13. And they got half of what he needed there, 2 yards. And it'll bring up a 3rd and 2 more. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Charles, and really the difference, obviously, was that 4th quarter. They dominated.
And it has to start with